Tuba, tuba, tubas. Oh, you tubas. Bird here. Bird here out on the front porch just a swinging. It's a drizzling rain. And just a mighty, mighty, mighty. Pipe got me dirty, Woga. Mighty, mighty. Good day. I was I've been wanting to come out here on the porch. Haven't been out here in a great long while. My lighter has been out here for all winter long. And that's a little dagger. Some people hang it on their belt. I hang it on my swing out here. And it has survived many nights out here all alone on the old porch swing. I've had that ever since. I guess they come out with it. It's drizzling rains. The frogs are hollering. Just mowed the grass. Just in time, the bottom fell out. I didn't get her weed-eated, but I'll do it in the morning. I'll get off work. No biggie. I mow it every week, so it's not much. Let's get a little housekeeping out of the way. Teaching a KT-209 Field Master Dublin from the OMS line of awesome, awesome teaching. Wet beyond. It's magnificent pipes. My good buddy Salon. Sipping on a little bit of his OMS coffee for his. My good old, yes it is. And mighty damn hot. Woo! Ouch. I'm here today to show off a new pipe to me. It's the last year Dagner Christmas pipe. I think they called it the Horn or something like that. Had something to do with an old German, I think, Christmas wild thing or whatever. Anyway, I seen the pipe at Christmas and it just didn't hit me. Those elbows looking pipes. And I had forgotten that it was a reverse calabash. And their newest pipe, which is a double Dublin, is a reverse calabash. And I didn't buy that one either. Sometimes I wait and try to buy some of these pipes. People buy them and think, oh, I really like that. I really want that. And then they don't like it. And they sell them on eBirds. And I'm going to get a deal on it. And I'm thrifty like that sometimes. It's hard to buy all the Dagner pipes and still feed your family. But anyway. Alright, come up on eBirds and Eric Pick, real good friend of mine. We got to hang out in Chicago a little bit and shoot. He gifted me a pipe, I'm sure you've seen it. Well, he hit me up right after we got back from Chicago. Dagner on smoking pipes. Sent me a link and I looked at it. And it was a good price. A very, very good price. The Dagner Christmas price. Oh, look on to what a beautiful teacher. You know, I still didn't like it when I seen it, and when I seen it, I thought it was the Dub Dublin. I seen the price, and I said, wow. And I had forgotten this was a reverse calabash. Well, I bought it and got to look at it, and I said, man, that was the Christmas pipe. I got all excited when I seen a Dagner for it. To me, these are OMS and Dagner. People can say what they want to. They're so cool. It's what got me into piping. Pipes look cool, you know? not saying the traditional, what my grandfather smoked, I've got all his pipes and my father's pipes in there and I love smoking now. But this was more me. I love the old pipes. I restore pipes and I love doing that. This drug me into it. It's different. And I'm a little different if you haven't noticed already. And it, since our time, you know, our fathers, it was their time, and things change, and I love old cars, I love new cars, and I collect them all, you know how it is. Anyways, nothing against the older pipes. This just got me started back into the hobby. I've always had a pipe since I was 18 years of old, where I wanted to be like my grandfather and my father. I mix my pipes. I just couldn't stick with it. I couldn't find anything I liked to shoot. And I was young and wild, not settled. You know how things go on your thing. But I tried to teach my pipes all the way up to. I'd get them down and teach them every now and then. But nothing regular up until about 11, 12, 13. I started watching YouTube. Watching the old pipe community come on in to the, just like I was talking about, the old and the new. Just up in here, and I liked all the faces that was coming into the community, and, you know. I'd all sort of got different. Got me interested. Something new always gets you interested. I found new tobaccos that were old to everybody else but new to me. I never ordered tobacco. Only tobacco I could get was what was at the CVS or a smoke shop. I didn't know what a B&M was until I started watching the YPPC. But any words, that's my little Dagner. And I want to do a VR for my good buddy, John Laughlin. Got to know him a little bit on House Party and whatnot. And, got on his channel and checked him out. And me and him sort of hit it off right off the bat. His dad went to the University of Tennessee. Go Vols. He's no volunteer. He seen I was from Tennessee, and the next video I seen him, man, he was playing Rocky Top, and he was getting down. I said, I like it, boy. But anyway, we met down in Chicago, and we got to chew together. He brought out some good old whiskey, some good old Japanese whiskey that was 12-year-old. And, man, we had ourselves a good old time. Yes, we did. We had ourselves awesome time. Me and him and Alex stay-at-home Piper and Fred and Tater, Justin Tater. We all went out to the car and trunk, had us a drink. Now Tater didn't have nobody to drive him. He did try a little bit of Jaeger, just a little bit, but he had to drive himself back. I had Miss Rhonda driving me, and of course Fred was with me. So we had us a good old time back there. And we got to know him really well, but he wanted to do a VR. And he's wanting to know what kind of bulk blends we'd like to stock up on. Well, this is the old dust on the bottle right there. This is some Luxury twist blade from Peter Stockerby. Lovely, lovely stuff. This is from Peter Stockerby Luxury Navy Flake. And some more Navy Flake that's been sitting around, Lord, 3 years. Been smoking out of this one. really like it. And this is a twist. You see right there, that was $60. That was that's what a $60, it cost me for a pound. And you see what I've done onto it. And then the bullseye flake that I didn't really ever care for because I didn't like vapors. But let me tell you, I'm into vapors now. And I just can't wait. Look what a beautiful, beautiful bullseye flake. I'm gonna tell you, if you're gonna go for some bulk, cheap bulk, and you like Virginias and vapors, Navy Flakes, I think Navy Flake has a little cabin dish off into it. And you can't beat this Peter Stockovich. You can get it cheaper than $60 a pound, too. I spend a little money at my local from time to time. For me, it's not about saving a dollar. Sometimes it's to help keep them going. Just look what some beautiful flakes. Picked up two minutes. Look at that. Oh man, got a hay. A lot of hay right there, boy. You tell me that's some good stuff. Oh my, my. And of course, everybody, I got a pound of each. And like I say, I give away some, smoke a lot. This is the luxury twist flake. Just the, when I smell onto it, to me it smells like granola and honey. And you talking about for a good summertime smoke, I think all these are good summertime. This especially. It's so wonderful. I had me a bow day before yesterday. Just hit the spot. If you're looking for something for the summertime, get you a little. Get you some. Four tears plenty good. I got on here. And you see that a lot of people smoking these things right here. They won't let you down. They age good. And I always gotta have me some. I've got 1,400 tampers and I'm out here without a tamper. But that's the way I roll, by the seat of my pants. Anywhere this video's getting I like to call them bitches. That's my Yabba Dabba, my OMS, my Dagna. I think it's a P17 one, Christmas type. Did I show you that it was a reverse calabash? It's a reverse calabash. You can see. And I haven't cleaned it since I chewed it. But that's one thing you gotta do. You gotta keep your reverse calabash clean. And I failed to do that. But just a nice chunk of bark briar, reverse calabash. I really like this pipe. That's my VR to John Laughlin. I like to call him Big John Laughlin. Big Bad John. And that's my bulk blends that I like to. I don't go after them. I just keep them around. I don't, you know, it's always plenty there. Good solid blend. And, you know, it's always available. That's what he wanted. He wanted to know a blend that we went after that was pretty available, you know, anytime. Sometimes during the summer when people start talking about it on YTVC, this will get scarce. But it'll be right back. You can find the summers all the time. But any words, I hope everybody's doing good. Hope everybody's going to have a good weekend. I got to work Friday. I only get one day off this weekend. But sometimes blessings are in disguise. I don't want to work. I'm mad about it. But I guess, you know, you got to get it when you can get it, I guess. Any words, Be good to one another. Be kind to everybody in the YTPC. Don't fuss and fight, please. Let's all be nice and understanding of one another. Look out for one another. Go watch one another's videos. Sub up on the newbies. Go sub John Laughlin. Go sub. Did I show you what I was teaching? I bet I didn't even show you what I was teaching. Teaching a little Private Benjamin Reserve that Fagleg gave me. This is blended for Sutcliffe. It's McClellan's Virginia's. Oh my, smells like Mater ketchup. He bought this for me down in Chicago. Tater, somebody found out that was there for sale for $13 a 10, and it was McClellan's Virginia's. Blend it by McClellan's for Sutler to make this blend. And Pegleg bought me a 10. Come back and pitched it to me. Benjamin Hartwell, Private Reserve, Signature Blend, Refined Virginia's, a very old type tobacco recipe. But yeah, if you see any of this, Benjamin Hartwell Reserve. It's mighty good if you like McClellan's Virginia's, that's what it is. To me, that's better than the 40th. I think it is 40th anniversary, but I don't know. Same type of Virginia flavor. Anyways, I'm going to put Fagleg down in the bucket. I'm going to put John Laughlin down in the bucket. Be kind to one another. Go sub a newbie, sub somebody you've never watched. Let's keep this thing going, the YTPC. And everybody, have a great weekend. And keep on teaching. I'm Bird. I am out. Oh, me, I'm out.